Yes. You can feel the Force, but you cannot feel yourself. You are a cipher, forming bonds, leeching the life of others, siphoning their will and dominating them. It is the teaching of these new Sith to feed on others, on other Force sensitives. They are symptomatic of the wound in the Force. You are a breach that must be closed. You transmit your pain, your suffering, through the Force. Within you, we see something worse than merely the teachings of the Sith. What you carry may mean the death of the Force, and the death of the Jedi. So you think. It is not the strength of a Jedi you feel.
He's right. It's all the death you've caused to get here. You feed on it, and you grow stronger. You're like Malachor. It's in you, it's what you are now. You must have noticed as you fought across all these planets, killing hundreds, only to become more and more powerful. Why do you think that was?
But what's worse is that bonding you have. It hasn't gone away. It's gotten stronger. And the more attachments you form, the more you draw others to you.
And that is why you are a threat to us all.
You know what the choice is.
If you don't warn them, then the Republic will fall. All those countless lives, innocent lives.
Or the one.
What if other Jedi went to war as you did, suffered the same events, and emerged as you did? What if there was a crucible that trained such Jedi to consume and kill?
For you, Malachor was that crucible.
What's worse is these Sith that we face. I fear that they have learned the lesson of Malachor all too well. It is what allows them to prey on Force users, to become stronger when Force sensitives are near.
Somehow they have learned their hunger from you. And so you have brought about the end of the Jedi, and perhaps all the knowledge of the Force. But it is of no consequence. Your ability to make such connections, such bonds, so easily are why you cannot remain.
And so you wait, as a shadow.
Yes, we are alike that way, blinded one.
I would have thought you would walk with her amongst the Jedi. But that is not the way of the Sith, is it?
Do not speak to me of the ways of the Sith. You, of all of us, have no conception of what it means to be Sith.
You are a threat to living creatures and all who feel the Force.
You will lead the Sith here, and that we cannot allow.
Our judgment before remains. Exile. You must leave. And you must leave without your tie to the Force. It is a punishment reserved for only a few, and only when necessary. But we have the power to cut you off from the Force, and it must be done.
Forgive us, but it is necessary.
Do not be afraid. You shall feel no pain, but this must be done. As long as you feel the Force, you are a danger to those around you.
Enough! Step away from her.
What?
Step away! She has brought truth, and you condemn it. The arrogance. You will not harm her. You will not harm her ever again.
I thought you had died in the Mandalorian Wars.
Die? No. Became stronger. Yes.
Is this your new master, Exile? If so, then you follow Revan's path. Her teachings will cause you to fall as surely as he did.
She is difficult to see. She's like a shadow of the Exile. We thought we were to sit out, and now they have come to us.
How could you ever hope to know the threat you face? When you have never walked in the dark places of the galaxy, faced war and death on such a scale, if you had traveled far enough, rather than waiting for the Echo to reach you, perhaps you would have seen it for what it was. Did you not hear its call on Dantooine, Vrook, on its scarred surface and in the minds of the settlers? I have endured your corruption of my other students. You shall not have this one. And you, Kavar, so close to the call of Duxan, tell me, did you not feel what poured from the moon, what had taken place there? And zez-kai, to hide upon Nar Shaddaa, yet blind yourself to all that happens there. So close to understanding the Force. So close to giving it up. There is a place in the galaxy where the dark side of the Force runs strong. It is something of the Sith, but it was fueled by war. It corrupts all that walks on its surface, drowns them in the power of the dark side. It corrupts all life, and it feeds on death. Revan knew the power of such places, and the power in making them. They can be used to break the will of others, of Jedi, promising them power and turning them to the dark side. Did you never wonder how Revan corrupted so many of the Jedi, so much of the Republic, so quickly? The Mandalorian Wars were a series of massacres that masked another war, a war of conversion, culminating in a final atrocity that no Jedi could walk away from, save one.
And that is what I sought to understand. How one could turn away from such power, give up the Force, and still live.
But I see what happened now.
It is because you were afraid. As you would pass judgment on her, I have come to pass judgment on you all.
Do you wish to feel the teachings born of the Mandalorian wars, of all tragedies that scream across the galaxy? Let me show you, you who have forever seen the galaxy through the Force. See it through the eyes of the exile. Take me to Atris. She will have the strength to do what the Council cannot.
What are we going to do? If we don't stop her, then everyone, everywhere, they're going to lose their lives.
If I lose her, it will be my failing. It is the failing of the Jedi who followed Revan. It is a failing of their teaching.
Soon your ship will come, my master. I will bring her before you, but I will not let you have her. Soon your ship shall come from that which made you.
I know you can hear me. I have always known. It is why I followed you.
I have destroyed planets for you, General. But now, this once, if we could save something in this galaxy. I need to do this, or I will die inside, like I died at Malachor 5.
Thank you.